Till now, explicit communication, is there any question? Instead of like I have told you that searching through all data, it will search through a limited data that is dependent upon one, okay, and will transfer it to next node.
Slide number 5
now. Okay, compression with explicit communication. Yeah, it is explained this only. Go to slide number 6. Distributed wavelet transformation. In distributed wavelet transformation, what we do is like here we divide the nodes into even and odd nodes. Okay, 1 and 3 are odd nodes, 2 and 4 are even nodes. So firstly, what it does? Yeah, firstly it's the even nodes that will transmit the data. Okay, that will transmit the data to both sides, 1 and 3. Okay, so when odd nodes will get this data, okay, they will then odd nodes will compute the high pass coefficient here. Okay, this will pass the high pass coefficient, okay, and then will transfer the data back to even nodes. Okay, then back this even nodes will pass low pass coefficient to this data and will send it to node. Okay, this low pass coefficient and high pass coefficient will reduce the amount of data that is to be transferred and will further send it to the sync node fastly. Okay, so this is the distributed wavelet transformation.
Can you please repeat?
Yeah, sure. Actually, what it is, in it, instead of like transferring all the data from one node to second node to third, third to fourth, okay, here it will be the old nodes firstly, okay, that will transfer, that will send the data to even nodes. Sorry, it will be the even nodes only that will firstly send data to old nodes, okay. Then old nodes will, go through this high pass coefficient, okay. These coefficients will be generated randomly, okay, through the sync. Actually, what it is, here is the sync. Firstly, it will send a random data to all these nodes, okay, and will check what these coefficients are being generated. Low pass and high pass coefficient that are being generated, okay. So what it is, now when it is transferring data, firstly even nodes are going to transfer data to all nodes, okay. These nodes will generate on the basis of this high pass coefficient data that has been generated, it is going to add the high pass coefficient to the data, okay, and will send it back to even nodes, okay. Now even nodes, what data they have received, okay, will add low pass coefficient to that data and will send it to the sync directly. So instead of like transferring from this data to this, this to this, this to this, these will directly transfer it to here, this will directly transfer it to here, okay. So it will like reduce the consumption of energy in those nodes. But basically these all techniques are older one only, and they have a lot of flaws. Slide 7. Yeah, basically this is also an older technique, slab wolf coding. In it, what we say is that we use the correlation technique at the sync, okay. That it means that instead of like separately encoding all these techniques, okay, we use a joint encoding technique over all these messages, okay, over all this data, and send it to the sync, okay. Like here we encoding a single data of with this. Here we are getting this older data and then it's encoding its data. Then it's encoding this data at again single is encoding all the data. So instead of this, okay, what they do is like it's going to the sync all the data and it's going to encode it jointly instead of the single one, and it will be sent to the sync and it will reduce the, it will be much more efficient. But this technique is also not very much important and useful here. Like advantages or disadvantages, that data exchange it won't take place, okay. Here decouples routing from compression, okay, that compression technique will take place, so it will like it will reduce the routing cost also. But disadvantages are like that only, that firstly we should know the global correlation for that, because at sync it is going to use correlation technique, so for that global correlation should be known so that all the data can be sent through correlation to the sync, okay. So that needs to be computed, but actually it can't take place in the large sensor networks. Slide 9. Compressive sampling. Yeah, actually compressive wireless, since compressive sampling, that is what it does, is it reduces the waiting period of data gathering. Like here, it was taking place at single hoop network, where it was taking that waiting, it is waiting for this data, okay? Then this was waiting for data from this, and it was sending it like that only, okay? So it reduces this tendency by sending a linear time projection, that how much time it will take. So these nodes can do other work for that time instead of waiting for that period only, okay? Here, slide 11, I have already explained to you about this, this one, baseline data collection, that first one is sending to 2, 2 is sending both the data to 3, 3 is sending all the data to 4, okay, and this is same taking place. So in compressive data gathering, I have already told you, in compressive data gathering,